Hi, this is Olga from agebury.com. In this quick video, I will show you how to use duckbill scissors. What do those funny looking scissors do? I am showing you everything you need to know about duckbill scissors and why you need them in your sewing toolkit. Duckbill scissors are a pair of funny shaped scissors with a wide flat blade and a slightly angled handle so that your hand is lifted from the fabric while you cut. The paddle blade, also called the duckbill blade, prevents you from cutting the stitches or the good part of the fabric. At the same time, the angle handle allows you to hold the scissors well while the blade is really flat on the material. Using the duckbill scissors, you can cut fabric very close to stitches, and that's why they are widely used in making machine appliques. But you still need to be careful. The cutting blade is very sharp, and if you go fast, you still can cut the good part of the project. I use duckbill scissors mostly for my machine embroidery and applique projects, when I need to trim fabric in the hoop. Trimming in the hoop is quite challenging, and I would say almost impossible without duckbill scissors. Also, embroidery and applique are my favorite ways to use these scissors. There are a few other times when they come in very handy. Snipping threads, cutting bulky seams, trimming batting and interfacing, grading seams. Duckbill scissors are incredibly helpful getting into tight spots where you need to trim something. So sometimes I use these scissors to trim the batting when making quilts, as I can cut very close to the seams without cutting the thread or the fabric. I also use them to cut the bulk out of seams where many seams meet. Duckbill scissors are also great when you make something using flat felt seams. You have to trim one seam edge and make it narrow, and the paddle blade of duckbill scissors keeps the part that you don't want to cut away from accidental cutting. There are duckbill scissors for left-handed people. Be sure to double check that the package specifies they are left-handed. Make sure you clean your duckbill scissors after each use before storing them, because lint is accumulating very fast on the wide paddle blade. So it's necessary to remove the lint on a regular basis. Keep the scissors fully closed when storing them. There are two different ways that people use duckbill scissors to accomplish the same task. Method 1. In this method, the wide paddle blade slides under a layer of fabric to push it up and away, allowing for a clean and close cut by the sharp cutting blade on top. For a right-handed sewist, you would cut around your project in a counterclockwise direction. For left-handed sewist, it would be clockwise. With method 2, you want the duckbill blade to be directly against your applique, protecting it. With this method for using duckbill scissors, you will do your cutting around your applique in a clockwise manner, so that the duckbill blade glides over your applique and your project and hard work are protected. If you are left-handed, you will cut in a counterclockwise direction for this method. Either way you use these scissors, the end result is the same. Neater cuts with clean, finished stitches all around your applique.